Another witness retracts his allegations against detained Philippine senator Laila De Lima after implicating the lawmaker to the illegal drug trade. Reports say Rafael Ragos, who was the former officer in charge of the Bureau of Corrections, says he was only coerced by then Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre. Back in 2016, Ragos had testified before the Senate that it was him who brought drug money to the home of De Lima. Now he's taking it back, saying it was all fabricated. He also apologizes to the senator, who has been detained for almost 5 years on several drug charges. Last week, self-confessed drug lord Kerwin Espinosa came out to retract his drug allegations against De Lima, prompting calls for her immediate release from detention. But Malacanang downplayed Espinosa's retraction, saying it will not have an impact on the case. Senator De Lima is a fierce critic of the Duterte administration's bloody war on drugs.
The Philippine poll body assures the public its investigation on the scrapped presidential and vice presidential town hall debates will not affect preparations for the May 9 elections. COMELEC Commissioner George Garcia gave that assurance after his fellow Commissioner Ray Bulay recommended the temporary relief of James Jimenez and Frances Arabe, both directors of the COMELEC Education and Information Department, following the debate fiasco. Garcia says COMELEC Chairman Saidamin Pangurangan has yet to act on Bulay's recommendation.
Dapat po ang focus natin hindi dito sa aming ginagawang investigasyon, kundi yung paghahanda natin sa halalan. Dapat dito yung focus, and then kung ano man po yung mga ganito, mga problemang ganito, after na lang po natin isosolve ito dahil may tamang panahon sa bawat mga bagay-bagay.
The COMELEC Town Hall debates were originally scheduled last week, but they were canceled due to the failure of COMELEC's third-party contractor, Impact Hub, to pay the venue. This prompted the poll body to conduct panel interviews with the presidential and vice presidential candidates instead. Catch some of those interviews on May 3 to 6, 2022 via the ABS-CBN online platforms ANC and ABS-CBN Teleradio.
The poor internet connection in some COMELEC offices may have resulted to the failed reactivation of 10 voters from Rizal Province. They will not be included in the regular voters database and in the computerized voters list for Election Day, despite their applications being filed on time. Another possible reason for the failed reactivation, their failure to appear during the scheduled online verification. Local poll officials say they tried to contact the applicants online but were unsuccessful.
Around 100,000 people showed up for the tandem of Vice President Lenny Robredo and Kiko Pangilinan in Cavite on Sunday. This was Robredo's third visit to Cavite for her presidential campaign, the second largest province in terms of voter population. This time, Robredo's hand was raised by Congressman P.D. Barzaga of the National Unity Party. Earlier that same day, Robredo and Pangilinan met with members of Kilusang Maya Uno, one of the Philippines' largest labor groups, after their Labor Day march. KMU has previously endorsed the tandem, lauding their commitment to adjust minimum wages and end labor contractualization.
Kapag siya na ang maging pangulo, siya ay tutulungan niya tayo, iangat niya ang ating buhay.
Ang mga pulisiya ng gobyerno dapat nagmumula sa kung sino ang pinaka-apektado, ang karaniwang Pilipino. Prioridad ang dignidad ninyo.
Meanwhile, Presidential bet Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. held a campaign rally in Isabela, one of the provinces in the so-called Solid North. There, the late dictator's son urged his supporters to also vote for his running mate, Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte, so they won't suffer the same fate as President Rodrigo Duterte and Vice President Robredo, who are from opposing parties. Marcos also attended a town hall meeting organized by the Trade Union Congress of the Philippines, where he promised to push for the security of 10-year bill if elected.
Security of tenure bill that we hope to amend and rewrite at ayusin para mapasa na Because kung ako'y pala rin at ako'y nakaupo, kung maganda naman ang version, pipirmahan ko talaga yan.
Philippine police barred a Labor Day protest led by presidential candidate Leonie D. Guzman from concluding at Mendiola. D. Guzman's group, Bukluran ng Magagawang Pilipino, was supposed to converge with his running mate Walden Bellios, Laban ng Masa, and head to Mendiola for their protest action. But authorities stopped their march, forcing them to end their protest in front of Far Eastern University. De Guzman has been actively campaigning for workers' rights as part of his election agenda for the May 9 polls.
Hindi na kami umaasa doon sa pangako niyang kontraktualisasyon. Ilalaban na lang namin yun sa susunod na administrasyon. Kung hindi ako, pero kung ako yan, automatic, mawawala na yung kontraktualisasyon. Dekadang laban ang dagdag na sahod, dekadang laban ang kontraktualisasyon. Dekadang laban ang hindi sa mababang presyo, pero walang pagtugon ang ating pamahalaan. Kinakailangan talaga na yung mga manggagawa ay magkaisa. Ito yung kailangan. Wala tayong mga asahan sa mga elitistang gobyerno.
Several workers groups also hit government on Labor Day, saying the daily minimum wage in the country is inadequate and discriminatory.
Bago umalis ang administrasyon na ito na hindi naging sapat ang pagtingin o malasakit ang tingin sa manggagawa, sana sa Mayong ito ay makapag-decide na po na mabigyan ng substantial increase sa minimum wage ang mga manggagawa.
Yung pong panukalang batas na pagdadagdag ng minimum wage gagawin 750 pesos, suportado po namin yan. At the same time, kasama po kami sa mga grupo na nag-file ng petition sa iba't ibang wage boards ng dagdag na sahod.
President Rodrigo Duterte and Vice President Lenny Robredo paid tribute to Filipino workers to mark Labor Day. In a statement, Duterte said the Filipino people have been known worldwide for the integrity and professionalism they demonstrate in everything that they do. He added, even if his term is ending, he will remain committed in providing Filipinos with opportunities to help them realize their full potential. As for Robredo, she said, anyone who works wholeheartedly and honestly not only contributes to the economy, but also to achieving dreams and strengthening the outskirts of society. She also said, in order for Filipino workers to thrive, their welfare must be prioritized.